everyone. Today we are going to take the next topic from the chapter quadratic equation. So today's topic is exercise 4.4. We are going to discuss the questions of the exercise 4.4 from NCERT. So before we start with that topic, first let's recall what we have done earlier. So let's recall what do you mean by nature of roots. So given any quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, we find the discriminant, and the discriminant d is given by b square minus 4ac. Now how the discriminant varies, whether it is less than 0, it is greater than 0, or it is equal to 0, what type of roots we have in that. So in case d is greater than 0, then we say that it has real and distinct roots, and the roots are given by minus b plus minus root d upon 2a. So the roots are real and distinct. That means the two roots will be real and they two are not equal to each other. They are distinct. Another case we have, when d is equal to 0, then we say that real and equal roots. So the roots of that equation will be same and the two roots are equal. So case 3, when d is less than 0, so we get no real roots. So actually the value of d tells us what type of roots the given quadratic equation have. If d is greater than 0, then we say that real and distinct roots. If d is equal to 0, then we say that real and equal roots. And if d is less than 0, then we say no real roots. Now we come to the next question. So I'm taking the next question, and my question is, I'm given a quadratic equation and we have to tell the value of k for which the given quadratic equation have equal roots. So sometimes something, when we say equal root, something comes in my mind that equal root means discriminant is equal to 0. So my first step. So how to start? Given the quadratic equation, I will compare it with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. On comparison, I get a is 2, b is k, and c is equal to 3. So I will find the discriminant now. Discriminant is b square minus 4ac. So k square minus 4 into 2 into 3. So I get k square minus 24. So here I have the discriminant and something equal roots. So something that comes in my mind is that for equal roots, discriminant is equal to 0. So put discriminant is equal to 0. K square is equal to 24. So take the square root on both the sides, I get plus minus. Don't forget to put the plus minus sign, plus minus under root of 24. 24 means 4 into 6. So 4 comes out of the root sign, I get my answer is k is equal to plus minus 2 root. So 2 root 6. So for k is equal to plus minus 2 root 6, the given quadratic equation have equal roots. Now I am taking another question based on the same thing. Given a quadratic equation kx bracket x minus 2 plus 6 is equal to 0. It's 0 has been written twice. So given this quadratic equation, I have to find the value of k so that it have equal roots again. But first I'm going to multiply this equation. I get kx square minus 2kx plus 6 is equal to 0. Now something that comes in my mind when I have kx square. So you should understand that if k is multiplied with x square, then k cannot take the value 0. Why k cannot take the value 0? Because if k becomes 0, then it will no longer be a quadratic equation. So as soon as you have such type of a question, you should understand that the value of k cannot be 0. So again, we have compared that equation with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. I get a equal to k, b is equal to minus 2k, and c is equal to 6. Again, I am finding the discriminant, b square minus 4ac, and my discriminant comes out to be 4k square minus 24k. Now for equal roots again, I will put discriminant is equal to 0. Putting discriminant is equal to 0, I get 4k square minus 24k equal to 0. Take maximum common, I have taken 4k common. So I get 4k into k minus 6 is equal to 0. Now what does it mean? So what values of k I am going to have from here? So this means either 4k is equal to 0 or k minus 6 is equal to 0. Here I have put an equal to sign. It is k minus 6 is equal to 0. So the two values of k is equal to 0 or k is equal to 6. But something I told you earlier, that k cannot take the value 0, because if k is equal to 0, then the given equation will not be a quadratic equation. So I'm going to reject k is equal to 0, and so finally my answer is the given equation will have equal roots only when k is equal to 6. So we can have another type of quotient in that. We can have another type set of quotient where we have find the value of k such that the given equation have real and distinct roots. In that we will put discriminant greater than 0. We can have no real roots, then we will put discriminant less than 0. So we can have infinitely many quotients based on this. So next type of quotient we are going to discuss is a quotient of these form. Is it possible to design a rectangular park of perimeter 80 meter and area 400 meter square? If so, find the length and breadth. Or we can have this kind of a situation that some of the ages of two friends are given and their product of their ages 4 years ago is also given. So we have to find that whether the situation is possible or we are able to design such a rectangular park. So for these type of quotient, we are going to use the nature of roots. We will form the equation. If the discriminant for these equations is greater than 0 or equal to 0, then we will say that this type of a design is possible or this situation is possible. So let's take one quotient, but before that one should also understand if my d is less than 0, then we will say that that type of a design or that type of a situation is not possible. So ultimately we should understand the nature of roots. Using nature of roots, I will be able to solve these type of quotients. So first question I'm taking on this, the same question which I have written previously. It is possible to design a rectangular park of perimeter 80 meter and area 400 meter square. If so, find the length and breadth. So let the length of the rectangular park be x meter and the breadth of the rectangular park be y meter. So what I get? Perimeter. What is perimeter? The sum of the four sides. So what I get? 2x plus 2y is equal to 80. That means twice I'm going to add the length and twice I'm going to add the breadth. So I get 2x plus 2y is equal to 80. So divide that whole equation by 2, I get x plus y equal to 40. So I have my first equation. Now I'm also given the area. What is area? Area is length into breadth. So x into y is 400. I'm putting the value of y here. Y from the previous equation is 40 minus x. So put the value of y, open the bracket. Finally, I get rearrange my terms and I get my equation x square minus 40x plus 400 is equal to 0. So either if you are able to solve by middle term splitting also, if you are getting your answer by middle term splitting, I can say that it is possible to design a rectangular park. So much easier is just find the discriminant. So let's find the discriminant. Okay, discriminant is b square minus 4ac. Calculated the discriminant, I get 1600 minus 1600, which is 0. So what I am getting? That my discriminant is 0. So that means it is possible to design. But what will be my answer? That I will have equal roots here. So what I get? Yes, the equation will have equal real roots and the situation is possible. So what are my roots? I will find the value of x. Sorry, if x is here minus b by 2a. So x is 20, y is 20, y, x and y both are equal because my discriminant is 0 and they are saying equal and real roots. So next let's take another question based on this topic. So is the following situation possible? If so, determine the present ages. Sum of the ages of two friends is 20 years. 4 years ago, the product of their ages was 40 years. So let's assume their present age, the present age of one friend is x, then the present age of other friend will be 20 minus x. 4 years ago, their ages will be x minus 4 and for the other it will be 20 minus x minus 4, that will mean 16 minus x. And then according to the quotient, you are given that the product of their ages 4 years ago was 48. So x minus 4 into 16 minus x is equal to 48. Multiply the whole bracket, rearrange the terms and I get x square minus 20x plus 112 is equal to 0. So I have my quadratic equation. I will find the discriminant now. If you are able to solve by middle term splitting, it's well and good. If not, use quadratic formula. First find the discriminant and let's see what the discriminant is. Yes, discriminant is minus 20 whole square minus 4 into 112. I get 400 minus 448, which is minus 48. And my discriminant is less than 0. So this situation is not possible. I will not be able to find the roots. So what I will say here? There will be no real solution possible for the equation. And hence the condition, that means that situation is not possible. Hope you are able to understand these type of questions. If you have any problem in these type of questions or any other problem, you can write in the comment section. Thank you, everyone.